Deriving the Principles of Special and General Relativity from the Duality of Time Theory. In this video we will see how the one simple postulate of the duality of time will lead to the three principles of special and general relativity all at once, while also producing a naturally granular space that lead to full quantum field theory of gravity as we shall describe in another video. The duality of time postulate states that at every instance of the outward normal level of time, space and matter are perpetually being recreated in one linear chronological sequence which forms the inward levels of time that are also nested inside each lower dimension of space. This means that at every instance of the real flow of time there is only one metaphysical point, that is the unit of space-time geometry, and the universe is a result of its perpetual recurrence in the inner levels of time, which is continuously and perpetually recreating the dimensions of space and what it may contain of matter particles, which then kinetically evolve throughout the outer normal level of time that we encounter. This geometrical point is the single monad that has been explained in the first volume of this series. The famous Michelson-Morley experiment in 1887 proved that light travels with the same speed regardless whether it was moving in the direction of the movement of the Earth or perpendicular to it. This unexpected result led to the first principle of special relativity, that the speed of light in vacuum is the maximum speed which anything in the universe can ever attain, regardless of the motion of the source, or the reference frame of the observer. However, even though it was confirmed by many experiments, there is yet no theoretical or philosophical account that could explain this constancy and invariance of the speed of light, but it is considered an axiom that has been experimentally verified, but not yet proven in any fundamental academic sense. According to the duality of time, the speed of light is a property of the dynamic space-time geometry whose individual discrete points perpetually fluctuating between the two metaphysical states of void and vacuum, corresponding to zero and the speed of light, respectively. All other states that produce the apparent physical properties of matter particles result from the spatial and temporal superposition of these two primordial states of each individual geometrical point. So the speed of light is the speed of creation that is the only real speed in nature from which all the other physical properties, such as velocity, acceleration, mass, energy and even the dimensions of space, are only observable on the outward imaginary level of time, and based on this genuinely complex nature of time they can be easily calculated form the basic principles of classical mechanics. The second principle of special relativity, which says that the laws of physics are invariant between inertial frames, and the equivalence principle that lead to general relativity, will follow directly from the complex time geometry in addition to exact mathematical derivation of the mass-energy equivalence relation E equals mc squared. All current derivations of this critical relation suffer from unjustified assumptions or approximations, as was repeatedly acknowledged by Einstein himself. The equivalence and transmutability between mass and energy can only occur in the inner levels of time, because it must involve motion at the speed of light that appears on the normal level of time as instantaneous. Hence the same fundamental laws of motion become inapplicable since they prohibit massive particles from moving at the speed of light, in the inner level of time. However, this would be the normal behavior because the metaphysical monads are still massless, and the continuous coupling and decoupling is what generates mass and energy on the inner and outer levels of time, respectively. In the genuinely complex time frame of the duality of time theory, Lorentz factor is equivalent to a rotation between the rest frame that is creating space at the speed of light c, and the moving frame of the observer moving at the imaginary speed vi, producing the actual speed v a as hyperbolic split complex number. Therefore, Lorentz boost is equal to cos theta. In the same manner, we can also obtain time dilation and space contraction. We can also easily discover the reason for the arrow of time, because the imaginary part of time is interrupting and delaying the real flow of time, so it can never exceed it, since they both belong to one single existence that is flowing either in the real inward dimension which is creating space at the speed of light, or in the outward direction which forms the imaginary discrete time, not the two together. Otherwise they both would be real as we are normally deceived, although the reverse arrow of time can still be conceived as the other disconnected branch of the hyperbola. And when these two opposite arrows of time meet, the hyperbola turns into a degenerate conic, and these two opposite time directions become one dimension of space. This condition occurs when the imaginary velocity is also equal to the speed of light, as the real speed. Additionally, the invariance of physics laws, which is the second principle of relativity, although it is not needed anymore, but it can also follow directly from the duality of time postulate, because the instantaneous speed in the outer level of time is always zero, which means that there is no any fundamental difference between objects moving at apparently different speeds, since in reality they are always at rest at the actual time of measurement. Of course, if the reference frame is in acceleration, this has to be taken into account in the same manner as in the previous figure, but by replacing the real and imaginary velocity with the corresponding momentum or energy, which will also lead to exact derivation of the equivalence principle of general relativity, as well as the mass-energy equivalence relation E equals mc squared, or the relativistic momentum-energy relation. Such exact derivations are not possible within the current frame of relativity, and they are not possible without postulating the inner levels of time.
All these calculations are described in detail in Chapter 5 of the Duality of Time book.
بسطت يدي من لي ألوس به إياك.